You might be new to genetic genealogy and you're wondering, okay, what is the best way to do matching on Ancestry? Ancestry happens to be the biggest database, and many people want to know, okay, what do I need to do to find the most success in my research? Well, today we're going to go over how to best do DNA matching on Ancestry. Now, the first thing that I think you need to understand is that Ancestry has actually done a lot of this work for you. In other words, they've pretty much optimized it by sorting your matches in most down to least order and giving you some hints as far as what relationship they're going to be in, and even grouping them into specific groups based on those relationships. So even a novice can get started and find a lot of information just by looking at the list that Ancestry provides you. But then you may be asking, okay, well, what settings should I use though? Well, let's go over to Ancestry and take a look at what settings you actually could change that might be able to help you. Now, like I said, in looking at this, you're going to have this list with each person and how much they share. It's going to start by those who share the most with you to those that share the least with you. But there are some settings that you might want to try out. So first off, getting started, you want to figure out where people match up with you. And so one of the settings that you can do is over in the trees category. There's three possibilities. There's private linked trees, there's public linked trees, and there's unlinked trees. I would suggest you start with public linked trees. Why you want to start with public linked trees is because these are the people who have had a tree created and it's linked to their DNA and you can look at it, which is great. That's what you want. So in this case, these first two people are the same because they're the closest relatives to my wife and she's already created trees that they're a part of. But the list now is only going to include those people who have those trees. So if you're just getting started and trying to find how some of these people might be related to you, then if they have a tree, you can start looking at tree and seeing if it matches up with yours. Now from that, you can also then go and I would look at the unlinked trees. In a lot of cases, people haven't linked their DNA to their tree simply because they didn't know how. And so you can usually determine who that person is based on their unlinked tree, and that might help you identify them. And then finally, there is the private trees. In this case, if you know that they have a tree and it's sizable, then you might want to email this person to either get access to their tree, or they might just be willing to tell you some information that you're looking for from that tree. Similar to the trees is the common ancestors. And in this case, what it's going to do is it's going to filter the list by those who have a common ancestor. So they have a tree, and on that tree, the computer at Ancestry has already identified that their tree matches your tree with these people. In other words, it's a common ancestor. That is an excellent clue of where to look to determine if this really is the most recent common ancestor. You need to verify that your tree is correct back to that person, and you need to verify that their tree is correct back to that person. So you can use the common ancestors to help get that list sorted down smaller to begin with. The next way to look at this is with the shared DNA. Now the shared DNA divides this up into two major categories: the close matches, which are your fourth cousins or closer, and the distant matches, which are more distant than that. Then you can also put in a custom setting. Now that really leads us to our next question. What should I not do? Because in this list, there's something that you should do and something you should not do. What should you do? Well, you want to look at your closest matches first. And so we could sort this by the closest matches. You can see here, there's 1,271 of them, and they share somewhere between 20 centimorgans and 3,490 centimorgans. So these are your closest matches. Fourth cousins are closer. They're the ones you're most likely going to be able to identify how you are related to them. What should you not do then? Well, starting off, I wouldn't even bother looking at these distant matches. Now you may be saying, well, there's 20,000 of them. Yes, there's 20,000 of them. you're never going to be able to get through all of them. Plus, most of these are going to be far enough distant from you that you're not going to be able to identify how you're related unless you can link them with other close matches. And there's going to be a sizable number of these that are false matches. In other words, you're not related at all in any kind of genealogical time frame. Let's say 10 generations or so. That means that the research that you're doing on those ones is going to be fruitless. You don't want to spend hours and hours researching a bunch of people that you're not related to, I would guess. So don't start by looking at these distant matches. Focus on the close matches. And really, I would focus on the way that ancestries actually outline the list from the most that you share DNA with down to the least. In the first couple hundred, if you are able to identify how the majority of those are related to you, it's going to make identifying the others much, much easier. And the last question is, how to best narrow down the matches to get the closest relations? With Ancestry, this is easy. They've done it for you. You don't have to really do anything other than follow the list down. You can see here it starts at full siblings, then it goes to close family, which might be aunts, maybe nieces and nephews, first cousins, and then it's going to get into the cousin list of extended family. So there's nothing you have to do for Ancestry other than go to your match list and then start researching these people, starting at the top and going down. That is your closest relations. Now, many people can get overwhelmed with the number of matches that they see there. Like I said, on my wife's, it was showing 22,000 matches. You don't need to research all of them. In fact, you're not going to have time to research all of them. You really do want to start on the ones that are most closely related to you or the ones that have trees that you can identify how you're related rather quickly. Now, if you saw those dots on there and you'd like to learn a little bit about how you can use those dots, watch this video up here. But if you want to learn something else about DNA, then take a look at this video down below.